I have gotten a very interesting question from one of my students in the online course on special theory of relativity. We normally say without questioning that if you have two frames S and S prime is moving with respect to S with a speed V in positive X direction, that means that S is moving with respect to S prime with a speed V in opposite direction. Now, this student has a question that if it is relativistic case, the lengths are different in the two frames, the times are different in the two frames, then how are you sure that speed, which is length by time, is same in the two cases? So, let me explain the question once again. Suppose I have a frame S. I have a frame S, and then I also have a frame S prime which is moving. This frame S prime is moving with respect to S in positive direction towards right with speed V. So, this frame will come here, then go here, and will go here, and will go here. And S says that yes, this frame is moving at this speed V. Now, as seen from this S prime, this S is moving backward, that is fine. But whether it moves in the backward direction with the same speed V or some other speed V, because the speed is distance by time, the meaning of distance from S frame is different, meaning of same distance from S prime will be different, the length contraction and all that. Similarly, the time interval between two events is different in S and S prime. So, how are you sure if the measurements are done from here and the thing in motion is here, it moves certain distance in certain time, this distance and time is measured from S prime. Whereas, if I am calculating velocity of this frame with respect to this frame, then the distance moved, the time taken is measured from this frame. And distances and times are different in different frames. So, whether the ratio will be same or will be different, that is the question. So, let us analyze this situation. First, I am talking from S frame. Okay, I am talking from S frame and trying to measure the velocity of S prime. And let me devise a way how to measure it. Let us say in S frame, there is a pillar out here at some distance d fixed. This pillar is fixed here on the x-axis. And what S does? S looks at the origin, this origin O prime, this origin O prime. And it says that, okay, when this origin comes here, when the two origins come coincide, that is my t equal to 0, that is the normal convention. And when the origin crosses this pillar, I will note that time and will say that, okay, S prime has moved d distance in that much time, and from there I will calculate this V. Right? So, at t equal to 0, at t equal to 0, this O prime is at O, and at time t, O prime is at x equal to d, that is the pillar. The origin has reached here. So, this is t equal to 0 situation, this is t equal to 0 situation, and this is the situation at time t. This origin has reached here. So, in t time, this S prime goes from here to here. So, it is this. And then it declares that, okay, V is, I know what is V, V is d by t. In t time, origin has gone from here to here, distance d, so it is this. Now, let us look at these same two events, origin crossing here, O prime crossing O. So, and O prime crossing pillar. So, these are the two events. And let us look at this from the point of view of this S prime frame. So, now I am drawing S prime here, and this S prime will be treated as fixed. This is fixed. This is S prime frame from where I am looking at everything. So, what will be the situation? The situation is S frame is coming from right and then coming and then crossing this S prime. So, let us say this is S frame and there is a pillar and this is coming with what velocity? Maybe say V1. So, this pillar is of course fixed with the frame. So, this entire thing is coming. So, the first event is this first event, origin crossing. This origin O reaches O prime. So, this is the first event. So, here is S. S has reached this point. S has reached here. This origin has reached here. So, O reaches O prime. Where is the pillar at this time? The pillar is here. The pillar is here. Origin of S is here. Pillar is here. And how much is this distance? This distance is not D. D was the distance between the origin and this pillar in S frame, in which the origin O is at rest, the pillar is at rest. So, D is the rest length between the origin and the pillar. But now, this whole length is moving from S prime, this whole length is moving and moving lengths contract. So, this distance is not D, this distance is D into square root of 1 minus V1 square by C square. This whole thing is coming, this whole thing is coming with velocity V1. So, this length with the rest length was D. So, this length in this frame is this much. So, after some time what happens? This goes further back and the pillar comes here. So, this is the next condition. The pillar comes here, the origin goes here. The pillar comes here, that is the second event. Same event here, origin O prime reaching the pillar. Here, pillar reaching origin O prime is the same event. What is the time? What is the time interval between the two events? See, these two events in this frame, S frame, have taken place at two different positions. The origin coming here, O and O prime coming together is here, and then O prime hitting this pillar is here. They occur at two different positions. But in this frame, see, O prime hits O, where? Here. Pillar hits O, where? Here. The two events are occurring at the same position. So, the time interval between these two events is proper time interval when it is measured from S prime, and it is improper time interval when it is measured from S, because in S they are occurring at two different places, in S prime they are occurring at the same position. And proper time interval is the smaller time interval, smallest time interval. So, here the time interval was T. Between these two events, the time interval was T. And therefore, here time at which pillar comes to O prime, pillar comes to O prime, that will be smaller than this T. And so this was t prime equal to 0, and this is at some t prime which is smaller than this, and therefore that t prime will be t multiplied by 1 minus v1 square by c square. Okay. This is a proper time interval, and s is coming with some velocity v1, and therefore the time proper time interval is smaller than the improper time interval, and it is this. So the pillar has covered, this pillar has covered this much of distance in this much of time. So what is the velocity of the pillar in s prime? The pillar was here, origin was here, and the distance was this much, and after that this is t prime equal to 0, and after that this much time has elapsed and this pillar has reached here. So what is the velocity of the pillar? So velocity of the pillar is d prime by t prime, everything measured from s prime. So I am getting velocity of the pillar in S prime, distance measured from S prime, which is much different from what it was in S, time measured from S prime, which is very different from what it was in S. Now the ratio, if you take ratio, this d prime is d into square root 1 minus v1 by square by c square, and this t prime is here t into square root of 1 minus v1 square by c square, and that is d by t. So you get the same d by t, same d by t here, same d by t there. So the lengths change, the time change, but they change by the same factor, and the speed of S prime in S and speed of S in S prime, they remain the same.